long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny. And now, at the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom.
Hello, this is Desh Radio. I am Ramesh Gupta, son of Lala Desh Bandhu Gupta, a well-known freedom fighter. This is the 70th anniversary video of Desh Bandhu College.
India's challenges were many. One of our greatest challenges was to try and give a home to those who had been rendered homeless during the partition.
Maulana Azad made a reference to the dark days of the partition and spoke about the terrible miseries that the people had suffered. They had lost home and family and loved ones and had nothing when they arrived here.
That is when the Ministry of Relief and Rehabilitation started their program in an attempt to bring education to those who had been displaced. It led to the founding of Deshbandhu College.
And in 50 years, what Lala Deshbandhu Gupta achieved, many great things that he did for the country at the time, and he was only a student in 1921. He went for the Mahatma Gandhi's call for Quit India Movement, and then he took that struggle and joined the freedom struggle at that time. Yeah, my father passed away in 1951 in a plane crash. A tragedy was there for the befallen on the whole family and all of us. We saw that Shri Ajit Prasad, who was the Minister for Rehabilitation, founded your college in my father's name. It was very apt, I suppose, because my father was involved in rehabilitation of the displaced people from Pakistan. And I think it is a great tribute to him and to his work that he used to have.
The college had a simple beginning with just about 75 students, a lack of proper water supply, electricity, and even the absence of a proper transport system. Yet what the college never lacked was an unwavering determination. Even though the students were few, it is a testament to the vibrancy of the student community that they managed to form a Hindi society, a science association, a Sindhi literary society, a Bengali association, an economic society, a dramatic club, and even a college union.
When I joined this college in 1979, I observed that culturally, the Deshbandhu College has a rich tradition. And already there was dramatic society, and the students were really producing excellent plays. The college used to invite professionals as directors to tell them everything about the production of a play. There would be theory classes where they would be taught what is play, how it is staged, how it is managed, how dialogues are written, and all these plays used to win prizes, and they used to go for the competitions, you know. Like for example, in IIT Pilani, BITS Pilani, in Shimla, there used to be a great cultural festival even at that point in time.
You know, there is this list, I mean, one can really read out a list of societies. That is Oculus, the Film Society, that is the Dramatic Society, both stage and street, and then there is the Magnificent Sharpshooter. Oh wait, just let's see it. We'll be right back.
The National Cadet Corps is a youth development and voluntary organization. It provides a big platform to all the cadets for their well-being. NCC Deshbandhu also provide a big platform to all the cadets in their prestigious camps like RDC, TSC, PM Rally and many more. The motto of NCC is unity and discipline. Thank you.
The sole aim of NSS unit Deshbandhu is to provide hands-on service to young students in delivering community service. The motto of NSS, not me but you, captures the essence of democratic living and upholds the need for selfless services. NSS helps the students develop and appreciate the point of view of others and also show consideration towards other living beings.
जब हम देशबंधु आए तो हमें पता नहीं था कि हम कहाँ आए हैं और बस दिल्ली आए हैं और कुछ दोस्तों के साथ आ गए हैं. हर कॉलेज एक देश की तरह होता है और उसमें हर डिपार्टमेंट एक राज्य की तरह होता है. तो हमें जो राज्य मिला वो बहुत शानदार था, हिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट. वहाँ के टीचर ने, हिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट के टीचर ने हमें सवाल करना सिखाया. जो हिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट में जो टीचर थे और उस वक्त जो उनके भीतर जज्बा था वो बिल्कुल वर्ल्ड क्लास था. और वो सिर्फ टीचर नहीं थे बल्कि उनमें से कई ए क्लास हिस्टोरियन भी थे. सुविता खत्री येल गई, अनिल सेठी कॉमनवेल्थ स्कॉलरशिप पे ऑक्सफोर्ड या कैम्ब्रिज गए. तो हमारे देशबंधु के हिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट ने जो हमें दिया है वो हमारी इतनी अच्छी मेमोरी किसी इंस्टीट्यूशन में, हमने कई जगह पे काम किया देखा, इतनी अच्छी कॉमरेडरी, इतनी बराबरी का अनुभव नहीं मिला हमें कहीं.
As I just enrolled for my MA, we had received this huge grant from the university and the department was supposed to go and buy books. I was a student still, but I remember my teachers in the department who insisted that I should be part of the team that would go to Daryaganj for this book hunt, because they felt that as a student I would perhaps be in the best position to decide which books to buy, to be absolutely aware of what books we had in the library, what books we needed. I mean, I just can't even believe that these were moments I lived through.
So I was always inclined towards nature and used to go to forest wherever possible, but it was the Deshbandhu College and the faculty there, particularly Dr. B.P. Saxena, who guided me for my career, and also a syllabus that we had, ecology and all. When I read it, I knew where I had to go. And today I am there because of the guidance and support of the faculty and the path that I chose.
What I am today in Delhi, you know, Delhi, it is because of the foundations laid down upon my career by this college. It was a small college, no resources, hardly any canteen. But teachers were committed to teaching the students. Some of the best teachers were there because they were committed to teaching rather than looking after good names. From 1965 to 2022, its journey is a journey of a college which is proud of its past and present.
मेरी जो हायर एजुकेशन की जर्नी है वो इसी कॉलेज यानी देशबंधु कॉलेज से शुरू हुई थी और मैंने बीए यहाँ से किया था. फिर उसके बाद मैंने एमए हिंदी किया यहाँ से. जो हमारे टीचर्स थे उस समय के वो बहुत अच्छे स्कॉलर्स थे अपने अपने फील्ड के. यहाँ हमारे एक टीचर थे प्रोफेसर ओम प्रकाश कोहली जो बाद में गुजरात के गवर्नर बने थे और वो डूटा दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी टीचर्स एसोसिएशन जो है उसके बहुत एक्टिव मेंबर थे और वो DUTA के प्रेसिडेंट भी बने थे. और सबसे बड़ी बात थी कि फ्रैक्शनिज्म से अलग होकर के वो लोग सबके लिए काम करते थे. तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा पॉजिटिव हो रहा है.
मैंने हंसराज कॉलेज और देशबंधु कॉलेज इन दो कॉलेजों में पढ़ाया है. देशबंधु कॉलेज में लंबे समय तक 1960 से लेकर 2003 तक देशबंधु कॉलेज में मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा. मैं वहाँ जिस भी कैपेसिटी में रहा, जिस भी रोल में रहा, वहाँ पर टीचर्स ने हर रोल में मुझे स्वीकार किया, एक्सेप्ट किया.
After joining the college in 1966, I remained in the college till 69, and I had the privilege of officiating as a principal in two or three tenures. And I always considered this college to be like a temple. And whenever I visited, entered the college, even now after retirement, I have the same feeling of reverence.
This has been the most memorable and most happy period of my life. I found that people around me, our students, everybody were so nice, and the college atmosphere was such, you know, there was such a bonhomie here. When I came to Deshbandhu College, I instantly felt that this is the place where I really belong.
1967 जून या जुलाई से मेरी एक इनिंग स्टार्ट हुई इस कॉलेज में. बहुत सुंदर तरीके से, बहुत अच्छी यादें जिसमें मुझे बेस्ट टीचर्स मिले. मैं सुन के आई थी कि कॉलेज में तो बस टीचर्स लेक्चर देते हैं और बच्चे अब जो चाहे उसको नोट कर लें, नोट्स ले लें, उनके ऊपर है. लेकिन इतना पर्सनल टच टीचर्स का, इतना खजाना है मन में इस पारी से जुड़ा हुआ. कॉलेज की स्टूडेंट होने के नाते एक गर्व मन में है, तो कॉलेज में अध्यापन कार्य में अपने गुरुजनों के साथ, उनके बताए हुए, उनके गाइडेंस के अंडर जिस तरह के मैंने अनुभव पाए, मैं अपने जीवन को बहुत धनी मानती
हूँ. We inherit a rich legacy of teaching and learning in this illustrious institution. What was introduced much later was done by us since beginning. We have had an illustrious tradition of debates, discourses, seminars. So teaching and learning is not merely about classroom teaching, which has been of a great and tremendous importance to us, all of us, but it is also important beyond classrooms.
My journey with IQAC started way back in September 2015. Road to success was not so smooth. College, being Constituent College of Delhi University, had limited financial resources and we had much to do. But with the persistent efforts of Team IQAC, continuous and unconditional support of our former and present principal, teaching and non-teaching faculty members of DBC family, and all our dear students, we have achieved many milestones. The credit of the success of IQAC goes to them all.
Deshbandhu College is very close to my heart and soul. I'm associated for more than four decades with Deshbandhu College as a student, as a faculty member, as a researcher, and now as a vice principal. I have experienced each and every phase with full satisfaction. At each point of time, I found Deshbandhu College nothing but excellent. The speciality about Deshbandhu College is teacher-taught interaction. This I remember when I was a student and also as a teacher. Deshbandhu College, their teachers are not just teachers, they are mentors. They won't only teach, they educate.
Namaskar Sathiyo, Deshbandhu College ke 70th Sthapna Divas par main aap sabhi ko hardik badhai और शुभकामनाएं प्रेषित करता हूं. निश्चित ही ये क्षण किसी एक के प्रयास या प्रतिफल का परिणाम नहीं है, बल्कि अपनी स्थापना से लेकर वर्तमान तक देशबंधु कॉलेज के प्रत्येक सदस्य, हमारे शिक्षक, हमारे नॉन टीचिंग, हमारे सभी छात्र और छात्राओं की लगन, अनुशासन का परिणाम है जहां हम आज पहुंचे हैं.
मैं ये आपको बताना चाहता हूँ कि वो दिन दूर नहीं है कि जब कॉलेज अगले एक दो साल में देश के 10 कॉलेजों में से एक कॉलेज होगा. ऐसी हमारी पूरी संभावना है और मुझे विश्वास है अगले दो साल में हमारा ये प्रयास होगा कि हम देश के 10 सर्वश्रेष्ठ कॉलेजों में से एक कॉलेज होंगे.
साथियों, एक बार फिर से आप सभी को हमारे कॉलेज के स्थापना दिवस की बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.